Let's solve some questions. The first one is that the length of rectangular plot given as 80 meters, its area has been given as to us as the 4000 meters square, and the breadth and perimeter are to be found. So how to do such questions? First of all, whatever data has been given, write it down. That is the length of plot. So we write the length of plot given us as 80 meters. Next, we are going to write the area of plot, which has been given to us as 4000 meters square. And we have to find out the breadth for this plot as well as the perimeter. So, do we have any formula known for both the unknown quantities? We know the formula for perimeter, but we are not aware of any formula for breadth. Then what should we do? Nothing, but you can just compare that all these three quantities, all the given data can be used to find out the unknown quantity. Do we have any relation between them? Yes, we do have, and which is equal to the formula of area of rectangle that used to be, which was length into breadth. Because here we have the plot, so we'll write area of plot equal to length into breadth. Now you can see you have been given the area, that is 4000. The length has been given to us as 80 and breadth is to be found. So we have automatically generated a formula for the breadth. So because we have already known how to solve this, we can solve it directly. The 80 goes to the denominator, reason being it was getting multiplied. When you transpose it to the other side, it's going to get divided, and when you solve it further, you're going to get value of B as 50, or you can write over here that breadth of the rectangular plot is going to be 50 meters. Now, as we have got the breadth, it becomes easy for us to calculate the perimeter also. As we know, that perimeter of plot, is it going to be 2 into L plus B only? How do we come to know? Because the plot was rectangular in shape, and we know that perimeter of rectangle is equal to 2 into L plus B. So we'll place the values of length and breadth, that is 80 and 50. We get 2 into 130, that gives us 260 meters. Now 260 meters is the perimeter of this rectangular plot. Moving to the second question, we have a 2 meter wide path running along inside of a rectangular lawn. A lawn is having the length as 30 and the breadth as 20 meters. We have to find out the area of that path. So first of all, let us understand and draw the figure to analyze what is the data given and what is to be found. So question number 2 is having the shape of a rectangular lawn, that is a rectangle. At first, you make a rectangle. Let's name it A, B, C and D. Now you have a 2 meters wide path running across it. That means inside you have drawn a 2 meters wide path across its length and across its breadth both. So I have constructed that path, and let us name this as E, F, G, H. Let us give the measurements also. The length of the lawn has been given to us as 30 meters and the breadth has been given to us as 20 meters. And what is the width of the path given? That is given to us as 2 meters respectively. So we'll mention the 2 meters length across each path. Now what are we supposed to find? We are supposed to find the area of path. Now here the area is represented with the portion that I am shading, right? The shaded portion here is representing the area that we are supposed to find out. Okay, now how are we going to find this out? First of all, I'll tell you the equation that you are going to use. The area of path is going to be the subtraction of area of ABCD and area of EFGH. Why is it so? Now I am going to explain it to you. See, you have the total lawn with you. You have this whole thing with you, right? And you want to take some piece out of it. I have the whole lawn. I have taken this EFGH portion. I picked it up and I pulled it out. How much is the area left now? The area left would be only the shaded portion that you can see. That means from the total area ABCD, you will have to subtract this particular portion, that is EFGH, and you will get your area of the path. So that means we are going to get it as soon as we get the area of ABCD and EFGH. So the next step should be for calculation of both the areas, and we do it like this: area of ABCD, because that is representing lawn. So I am going to write area of lawn in brackets ABCD equal to length into breadth, as it was rectangular in shape. So what is the length of the lawn given to us? 30, and the breadth is given to us as 20. So we get 600 meters square as the area of lawn. Moving to the next one, we have area of EFGH. Because we do not have any such name given to that place, we can name it as rectangle, right? So you can write area of rectangle EFGH would also be equal to length into breadth. And now the twist comes. How will you find out the length and breadth? Because here we are not given any such data regarding the length and breadth, but we are given the very important part, that is the width of the part. The width of the part here is given as 2 meters. That means this is 2 meters wide in each case. Now that can be used to find out the length and breadth for this one. How do we use that? The total is how much? 30. You need to find out only from here up till here. So that means out of the total length, you will have to subtract this and this. You will be remaining with this much. And how much is this? This is 2 meters and this is 2 meters. So in total, how much are you going to deduct? You're going to deduct 4, right? So the length will be equal to 30 minus 4 meters. Similarly, we are going to calculate the breadth. The breadth total was of the length lawn was the 20 meters. Out of that total, we are going to subtract this 2 and this 2 to get us the breadth of the lower one. So we write over here 20 minus 4 meters. And here we have 30 minus 4 as 26 meters and 20 minus 4 as 16 meters. Now let us solve this. 26 into 16 would give us 6 2s are 12, 13, 14 and 15. 6 and 2, you get 6 and 5, 11, 2, 3 and 4, giving us 416 meters square. So we have got the two areas now that we were supposed to find out. The final step would be to find out the area that was required. So we'll write over here the area. Let us make it rough. Now the area of path would be equal to the subtraction of both, that is 600 minus 416, giving us, let us do it here, 600 minus 416. Here you get 4, 9 minus 1, 8, 5 minus 4, 1. So you get 184 meters square as the area of path that was required to be calculated.